You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
For the community, by the community.
Welcome to 2014. Congratulations. You made it. Happy New Year to a survivor. Oh my goodness. How exciting. It's the new year. 2014 is here. You made it. You survived, right? But you better get yourself a GPS. So that you can thrive in 2014 and be totally successful. Yes, a GPS. I'll be right back to tell you all about it. Don't you touch that remote now.
Get ready to find hope. Get ready to be inspired. Get ready to discover your full potential. Get ready for total success. From the Total Success Coach, Princess Bola Adelani.
This is Princess Bola, the Total Success Coach, welcoming you to Inspired Success, your monthly dose of inspiration power, the program that equips you with the power and inspiration for total success. That is success at work and in life. Oh, wow, 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 wow. We made it, we made it, we made it. Congratulations. It's a brand new year. How exciting, how exciting, how exciting, how exciting. And you know, my mission, as always, is to make you totally successful. My mission is to equip you with the power, the knowledge, and the skills for you to realize all your dreams, all the goals you set for yourself in 2014. And today, we're going to be talking about the GPS that you need to be totally successful and to thrive in this year. Yes, the GPS, a GPS. I'm not talking about the global positioning system. I'm talking about getting yourself a guide to position and support you. Guide, position, and support. We're going to be talking today on Inspired Success about the mentor effect, the power and impact of having a mentor, which is really what the GPS is, a person who guides, positions, and support you. And I have with me in the studio to talk about this, this conversation is none other than a very dear friend, but also a protege of mine, the president and the founder of Your Choice Coaching. She also is a coach, Miss Janet Powell.
Hey, it's wonderful to be here, Princess Bola. I'm very excited about the show and about this year moving forward. So thank you for having me.
My pleasure. Mm. My great, great, great pleasure. So let's dive into this conversation right away. You have a master's in education. That's a certified coach yourself. Exactly. You've been coaching for about 4 or 5 years now or more?
Just about a little more than that.
Yes.
But in terms of experience, yes.
Yes, roundabout. Absolutely. Mm-hmm. And but you are a trained teacher, you know, and all of that. That's your background. How did you actually get into coaching?
Well, for a while I was in education, loved teaching, loved working with students and with adults alike. For a while I was supporting teachers in the classroom.
Mm-hmm.
But I think I found that while I was attempting to help teachers, there was this realization that any kind of change that is needed, the person involved themselves needs to take a high level of responsibility for what they're doing and be focused on the goal for themselves, not the goal that I bring for them, but the goal for themselves. And it began helping me think a lot more about what that actually means in terms of moving forward. And I began to look at various other support areas, whether it was psychology, mentoring, training, and kind of came upon coaching and realized, that's the thing that I'm looking for.
Okay, that's
the thing I'm looking for.
Amen. And so where did you get your certified from?
So I trained with a life-forming coach based out in Virginia, a Christian-based coaching organization.
Okay.
I trained, did their initial program, and then went on to work and deliver just very short coaching programs with them.
Okay.
And I'm still connected very much to life-forming, yes.
Is it called life-forming?
It's called life-forming coach.
Life-forming coaching.
Yes,
okay,
and they're based
great.
In Virginia.
Virginia, that's wonderful. That's wonderful. Yes. Now, let's talk about the difference between mentoring and coaching. Mm. Because for me, I think they could be used interchangeably, and they often are, you know, training, mentoring, coaching. But there's slight differences and slight overlaps, you know.
Absolutely.
So, but let's talk about that, because this is a word that people often use and really find hard to define.
Right.
You know, so what is, who is a mentor?
A mentor is someone who possesses a range of skills, expertise, experience that they are willing and wanting to share and support and teach a mentee with. In coaching, the coach is more focused on the goal of the person that they're coaching. The person comes with an understanding that they want to move forward, and their coach almost helps them to shine light on what they already have, pull out their own strategies for moving forward.
And in addition to that, I think that a coach also focuses on a particular subject matter and goal that you know, their client has, you know, so it's a particular, it's more specific to a particular topic or area of need, whereas a mentor, I see it as more of a personal interaction with somebody who has broad, very broad expertise and has attained a level of success that the mentee is trying to get to. So they have a more broader overview, and it's a more personal relationship than the coaching and the client, which I feel can is more of the professional kind of relationship. So yes, absolutely, I agree with you that in coaching, the client takes what do we call them, coachee or mentee?
The coachee or the client.
The client takes more responsibility about, you know, and the coach just kind of pretty much highlights and helps them to see better things that are in them or could be possible obstacles, you know. So welcome to Inspired Success. 2014 is the year. The mentor effect, the power and the impact of a mentor is our conversation with my very good friend. She's now become a very dear friend of mine, as well as a protege, and you'll be surprised about that. And we're going to get to that one, because you're looking at her. She's a professional colleague of mine as well, because she's a certified coach. This actually debunks certain myths that I feel that people have about mentoring and mentors and mentees. I think that oftentimes people don't think peer mentoring. People often don't think about spiritual mentoring. And, you know, so when they think of mentoring, they think age-wise, you know, the older mentoring someone younger, and they think of younger women and us, you know, a little older women mentoring youngers and all of that. But that is absolutely not what mentoring is all about. Mentoring can be with a peer, you know, and, you know, because we're all in different places.
Right.
You know, your peers can be further than you are in a place where you would like to attain in certain areas of life.
Absolutely.
And so that's where the mentoring comes into. You know, so let's now begin to talk about the power of mentoring, because, you know, I think that in faith circles, you know, this is something that is totally, I think people are oblivious to the, I think that is the best word, to the power and the impact of mentoring. And yet it is a very, very biblical principle and strategy for success. We see it littered all over the pages of the Bible, but yet for some reason we are not intentional about applying the principles, you know, and applying this principle to help, you know, believers develop, to help them grow, to help them walk in their destinies. Yet corporate America is running with it. I know a lot of corporations today who have mentoring programs, a lot, especially the bigger corporations. I even know of academic institutions. I know your daughter just went to college, for example. Right. And then they have mentoring programs where, you know, their peers or someone who's the freshman or sophomore may be mentoring kind of the freshman and all that. So it's a very well recognized strategy that is intentionally used out there, except unfortunately the faith community. So, but let's talk about the power and the impact of mentoring from a biblical perspective.
Who comes to mind immediately is the relationship between Eli and Samuel. Mm-hmm. Of course, we know that...
So we have Eli and Samuel. So let's think about a couple more. Yeah. We're talking about Old Testament now. So let's stay there.
We have Paul and Timothy.
That's a New Testament one. Uh-huh.
We have, of course, Jesus and his disciples.
Yes, we have Jesus and his disciples. We have... we have Elijah and Elisha in the Old Testament. We have Moses and Joshua. We have Ruth and Naomi. I mean, and the list is endless. And I'm sure that is not exhaustive, you know. So you got it, you know. So biblically, and then Titus talks about the you know, older women. Right. Mentoring the younger women and so on and so forth. Mm. So we see there, it's there in the basis of scripture, but we just don't utilize it. And in those cases that we've shared, what is the kind of impact, the effect that the mentor had in the life of their mentee?
Well, yeah, I referred initially to Eli and Samuel because that is a striking relationship to me in that when Samuel first heard the voice of God, he didn't know that it was God speaking to him.
Yes.
And several times he went to Eli and explained the situation, explained to his mentor what had happened. And it was Eli who discerned what was happening.
Absolutely.
And in doing that, he was able to instruct Samuel how he should respond, what he should say, and what he should listen out for.
Yes.
And right there, we have a mentor-mentee relationship where one person, because of a lack of experience, perhaps not necessarily knowing how to discern or how to even recognize the voice of God, very quickly learned from the experience of one who had gone ahead of him, Eli, and was able to answer God the next time he spoke.
God was calling him. He had a prophetic call. God was speaking to him. He was a prophet. This was God calling him. He helped him to discern the call of God upon his life and respond to it. And we see that also in other examples, you know, with Mordecai and Esther, you know, how it was Mordecai that helped her to discern her calling, her destiny, her purpose, and how to walk in it. Because Esther would have left this planet without fulfilling it. She didn't know why she was in the palace. So that really tells you really the power and the effect that having a mentor, you know, has in one's life. It is a matter of destiny. It is a matter of purpose. It is a matter of reaching your calling and your destiny. That means that without that connection with somebody, you know, to guide the GPS, to position you and to support you, you can really go through life and never achieve your destiny. You know, and so that is how crucial it is. That is how crucial it is. And so, you know, our mentoring, our relationship in that sense started about 6 months ago.
That's right.
You would say with the yes. Upper Room experience. Mm-hmm. Like I said, it was more of a spiritual, it is more of a spiritual mentoring, but I feel that the relationship, like I said, with a mentor, which is different from a coach, is that it's broader. Because a good mentor should have a very broad experience about life and the things of God. So now you speak to that. You speak to that.
Absolutely. So Princess Bola, to be honest, the thing that particularly attracted me to our relationship and still attracts me to our relationship, I believe, is having someone who has a frame of reference that I can tap into. There are many things in the spiritual realm and world that I have maybe experienced but have no real language for, maybe have not, in some cases, not even a kind of biblical understanding of why it is. And being able to just have somebody to go to ask questions, but also somebody to point me in a direction. Because one of the things I like about my relationship with you is that rarely do you give me the answer. You usually send me back to consider either what the Bible says about something, to talk it through with the Lord in prayer, to develop my own gifts of discerning. And in doing that, even if I come to the answer myself, I still have somebody with whom I can check and bounce it off. And for me, that is extremely important and very validating.
I want to kind of put some kind of perspective here, because if you're listening, if you're just tuning in, we're talking about the mentor effect, the power and the impact of a mentor, and having this GPS, this guide, this person in your life who's guiding, positioning, and supporting you in the journey in 2014, because it's a journey you don't really want to take by yourself. But I want to paint a picture here, because we're talking about peer mentoring here. I'm a coach, so you know I bring some coaching skills into that mentoring relationship. I'm a teacher myself, you know. I'm not as certified as you, but I am a teacher in my gifting. So I bring a lot of those elements to that mentoring relationship. But we want to put perspective here. I want viewers to be able to understand that prior to the relationship, you had a background of professionally being accomplished, your coach yourself, you had a great measure of success, and spiritually you're not a novice. How long have you been a Christian?
Well, I answered the call to salvation, said yes to Jesus at age 11.
It's been quite a while without giving our age.
Absolutely.
But you know, yes. So it's been quite a while. And how profound have you said this last 6 months has been in your life? You know, I mean, you've had other kind of relationships with spiritual leaders, but never one you could call a mentoring kind of relationship.
No.
So how has this relationship with me as a spiritual leader, but then as a mentor to you, different from everything else you experienced in the church? How is this different?
I would say that much of the guidance I've had in the past has been on a basis where I have come to a group, maybe. In some cases, individuals, but within the format and structure of a group. And a lot of the guidelines have been, and the help given and support, has been in the context, really, of the group.
Yes.
And the way things are working, whether it's a prayer group, a Bible study group. So that's been good and supportive. And there have been occasional places where I've been able to bring questions and interact with a specific leader. However, this relationship is different because I feel the reciprocity that is there. There is a sharing of, in this case, some very personal experience.
I'll just stop you there. The reciprocity, I think, also speaks to the intentionality. The intentionality. So I'm talking about you go get a GPS. That means it is implied that you go purchase one. You take steps to seek one out intentionally.
Yes.
So in the kind of church setting, it is not an intentionally defined mentor relationship. The leader is not realized that they're not mentoring you. They just say they're looking out for your soul. It's just general. But I think in this relationship, it's more intentional and it's more understood what the relationship is.
Right.
And so I think that is very crucial in establishing a mentor relationship with someone. It has to be identified and intentional. And both parties have to know that
right.
we are in this relationship
yes.
and this is how this relationship works.
Yes.
I'm learning from you. I'm shadowing you. You're pouring into my life. You're guiding me. You're positioning me. You're supporting me. And I, in turn, have things that I am also pouring into your life. So that's the reciprocity there. And then also you were going to say about, I don't know whether that was what you were going to talk about,
yes.
but I was also wanting to know about the depth, because there's the depth that comes when it's a little bit more personal, when it's personalized.
Yes.
And also when you are the one who is kind of actively seeking it out.
Yes.
And so it is the depth that then brings the transformation. Yes. So you talk about the depth. And you talk about the fact that even though we're talking about spiritual mentoring here, how has this relationship impacted other aspects of your life in terms of, you know, whether it's be your personal, your marital life, your financial, your parenting, all aspects of your life. How has this really helped to enhance those other relationships, just your whole life?
Wow. Let me start by saying, one of the things I particularly love about our relationship and being mentored by you is that you have some spiritual wisdom, experience, knowledge that I long for. And so I'm interested in just understanding how you came to be as if expert is the word, but full of expertise regarding the things of God. I've been able to observe some of your prayer habits. I've been able to observe your ability to minister and interact with people. I've observed the power and transformation that your life and ministry has on others. And my question is, how did that happen? And I'm hoping and I'm seeing that in this relationship, I'm learning how to do some of that myself.
Good. And that's another power and effect. And that's another way that mentoring is a little bit different from coaching. You see, because you're talking about shadowing me, you know, and that's where I talk also about that. How it's a little bit more personal when you're with a mentor, because this is how Jesus did it too.
Yes.
He modeled it. He did it, the action steps in front of his disciples. He lived out his life with them. And from without him teaching, always instructing, they could learn from his life and his habits from him. You know, they shadowed him. And they picked up certain pivotal things and they would ask him things. Why couldn't we cast out that devil?
Right.
Why couldn't we do it? And you did it. And then he will explain and say, you know, because of your unbelief. So that's kind of how it works with a mentor. And, you know, we're talking about the mentor effect. And 2014 is your year, not just to survive. You survived 2013 to 14. This is your year to really thrive and be totally successful. And I'm teaching us today, sharing with us today, rather, one of the most profound, powerful spiritual principles for your success. For you to thrive, it is to get a mentor, get a GPS, get a coach, get somebody in your life who is going to be there, who is where you'd like to be, or at least going in the direction you like to be, because that's huge. Just not anybody can mentor you,
right.
and not just anybody can be a mentor. There has to be a certain level of wisdom and experience and accomplishment that they have. They must be in a place where you'd like to be. They must have qualities and characteristics that you would like to have in your life, you know, and then, you know, be intentional about that. And because I have come to now really understand and value the power of a mentor, I've created a mentoring program just for you for 2014. I have created something. It's going to be in a group setting, you know, but at the same time, each mentee of the group is going to have an opportunity to personally interact with me. You know, I'll have the opportunity to take them on the road with me. They have the opportunity to shadow me. They have opportunities to ask me questions, just like Jesus had 12, you know. I'm talking about a small group number that I really want to work with in 2014. And I really would like to invite you to be a part of that. And you know where to find me. You know absolutely where to find me. You know, if you go to Facebook, LinkedIn, hey, royalproclamations.com, I am right there. And, you know, you may check it out and you may say, you know, it doesn't work for me because there has to be a certain, it has to be a fit. Our personalities have to, you know, merge. And you have to really, really believe that it is I'm somebody that God wants you to connect with. But, you know, at least check it out. Check it out, royalproclamations.com. Mm-hmm. And in 1 minute, what would you say? Why would you advise as a coach yourself, as an accomplished professional woman, as a woman of God, as this leader as well, yourself, why would you encourage somebody in 1 minute? What would be the core thing that you would say, you know what, would be their takeaway from a mentoring relationship like this, you know? What would it be? One thing that you think would totally be a huge takeaway for them.
I would say, first of all, we all need guidance, positioning, and support. Mm-hmm. It would be a mistake to think that we don't. And I have been overwhelmed with the level of commitment that my mentor, yourself, has to me. I've recognized that there are things in me that I don't see for myself. And the fact of having someone with such experience, commitment, and love identify in me and help me find the steps to pull it out, put it into practice, and get going on an area like this, I never could have done that without help. I simply wouldn't have seen it.
And so in one word, you would say you are working in destiny, you've been transformed, you've grown, it's impacted your relationships for better, every area of your life, there's been a transformation, there's been a growth, and there's been a discovery self of who you are, and unleashing of certain gifts in you that you didn't even really know that you had in you, an activation of certain innate giftings, and a confidence that comes from knowing, you know, there's somebody here saying, you know what, I believe in you, you can do this, you've got greatness on the inside of you, and saying, come on now, you go, you know. So it's all of that put together, and we could all use that. Mm-hmm. You are not, God didn't design this thing to be a solo walk, you know, it's not solo. I always say this all the time, only God self exists.
Right.
Only God is self-existent. And hello, you're not God. Get yourself a GPS. Get more information about my program, royalproclamations.com. The power and the impact of a mentor will change your life. And I'm not kidding you. It will catapult you to another level. It will transform and revolutionize your life. Get in contact with me. Come on now. Let's do this work together. I'm very committed to your success. I'm totally committed. And I look forward to sharing 2014 with you, this journey of destiny and greatness. And thank you so much, Janet.
Thank you.
We don't have much time. You know, we're not out of words. We're only out of time. But, you know, thank you so much for coming to share. I know you have so much more. And then on January 17th at 6:30 p.m. at St. James Episcopal Church in West Hartford, Connecticut will be the open house. Please come and find out more about this mentoring, leadership, and training program that I have just for you in 2014. Thank you, Janet.
Thank you, Princess.
Mrs. Princess Bola Adelani, reminding you to keep smiling. Hey, put a smile on your face in this new year. Come on. Keep networking, keep learning, keep believing, keep on keeping on. You're on the winning side. I look forward to seeing you next month. It's going to be another very inspiring segment on Inspired Success. God bless. Bye.